Hi guys and welcome back to our channel. Today we'll be analyzing three cryptocurrencies which are Tezos, Ethereum and Litecoin against US dollar. We will also be reviewing our trading robot as performed over the time. So please subscribe to our channel if you want us to keep releasing technical analysis for free. While if you want to receive our weekly newsletter, our on-demand analysis and overall our real-time alerts, then you might want to join our growing community on Patreon. You will find the link in the description field. Let's start with the Tezos on a weekly basis, which means every candle is a weekly one. As you can see here, right now, Tezos is worth $2.50. Our strategy, being a breakout strategy, will open a buy long only above $6. The reason is because Tezos is enveloped inside a huge rectangle between $6 and $2. So our first target after having broken above $6 is definitely the all-time high around $12. So right now we don't open any long for Tezos. We will be waiting for the breakout of $6. Now let's move on. Let's see Ethereum. For Ethereum, I would like to start evaluating our trading robot. As you can see here, Ethereum was a buy long on November 9 at $460. Right now, Ethereum is worth $1,200, which means between $700 and $800 of gain. So what we see here at the time on November the 9, we had a score of 8 points, which means all our indicators in over different time frames were positive. Right now we see 7 positive out of 8 indicators, so we see that still the white curve for our first cycle is above the orange one, while for the second cycle we see that the red curve is below the azure one, so it's a very first alert signal. But since we still have 7 points out of 10, for us there are no reason to close our long positions. Now if we analyze our proprietary trading signal, we see this is a weekly chart, that this is a Litecoin. Let's move on. Let's switch to Ethereum, and then we will see how it what our proprietary indicator are telling us for Ethereum on a weekly and on a daily basis. So what we see here on a weekly chart is that both the two curves are above the zero, which means the derivative is positive, with the green curve in this case above the red one, in this case above the blue one. Now if we switch to the daily chart, we will be analyzing where we are, and as you can see here, we are still positive. We don't see any green curve breaking below, in this case the red one, and breaking below the blue one. So for us, it's still we're still in a strong uptrend, and we don't see any reason to close our longs. What I've suggested to my patrons is to use a trailing stop in order to lock into profits. Now let's see what we can retrieve for Litecoin. Okay, for Litecoin we see that on a daily chart the white curve is still above the orange one, which means the cycle is still positive, and same situation for Ethereum for the second cycle with the red curve below the azure one. Now if we switch to the weekly chart, we see where we are, and as you can see here, we are still positive for the two curves. So even in this case, we don't see any reason to close so far our long. And as you can see here, I've been plotting two triangular moving average using as envelopes, and as you can see here, the price has been rejected by the upper envelopes. The reason is because the two envelopes should take into consideration 95% of the data. So when we break above the upper envelope, that means that the trend is extremely strong, but in this case we are inside the 5% of movement, so we are inside an extreme movement. Now if we switch to the weekly chart, and we need again to use Litecoin, we will see where we are with our proprietary indicators. Okay, so here we have the daily chart, and as you can see here, in both cases we still have a positive signal, so the system has not close our buy signal so far. And let's switch to the weekly chart in order to understand where we are over the weekly chart. As you can see here, And the two property indicators are working in a very brilliant way, with the green curve being above the red one and above the blue one. We are still inside the positive momentum. Of course, if we want to use a breakout strategy, now we, and if you are not holding Litecoin, I suggest to enter in position only at the break of $200. The reason is because, as you can see here, we are now facing a horizontal resistance. In other words, so far the price has been testing the 200 threshold, the 180 threshold, almost 200 threshold. From there, we've seen that actually it has been rejected. This one is a weekly chart, so what we see here is a long white candle, a doji, and a hammer, which is definitely a negative pattern. But until we will not see the red, in this case, the green curve breaking below the red one, and same here below the blue one, we are not going to close our position until or unless our trailing stop has closed our long position for us. Now let's again be back to our robot system. Actually, here we see a lot of entry points for the SP 500, DAX 30, and FTSE MIB. Our score was 6 points. We are actually in a profit for Bitcoin. Our trading system, our robot, became long, gave a long position on October 19 at 12,750 points. Right now we are around $40,000, and for Ethereum 9 November at 461. So same here, the only short was for Alibaba 10 November at $267. So far we have a 100% rate of success, which is, I guess, unbelievable. I do believe we are going to hit some wrong trade over the time, because I don't believe that a trading system can perform at a 100% rate, yet it seems to be a very robust trading system. So, guys, if you want to get access to our trading system, you might want to join our Tier 2 on Patreon. Thank you, guys.